Good morning. So, I know it's just me. This morning, it's Mindful Monday, and what we've got, what Gazelle Shiloh has created for us, is these beautiful affirmation cards. So I will upload these into the comments. And y'all can print that out and color those, have a little bit of time and some mindfulness. So what I'd like to do for you, it's not going to be too long here today, so we'll just spend a mindful moment and share these. It looks like I looped. I'm looking at the time. It's showing only like 30 seconds. So let's do that again, huh? So, anyways, hi, it's just me. Welcome to Monday. What we have today is these beautiful affirmation cards. So I will talk a little bit about what affirmations are. I'll upload that into the comments so you can have your mindful moment and do a little bit of coloring. So let's do a little meditation. Affirmations are amazing. They take a little bit of time to get in the habit of, or at least for me, that was the case for me. So an affirmation is a reaffirming positive statement. So the affirmations that we have that Gazelle has printed for us is, I am calm, I am caring, and I am confident. And what a great statement any one of those would be to incorporate into your day, one at a time or all three. I like to do affirmations. I pick one every day. That's part of what I do in my journaling and my gratitude. So I get up in the morning and I pick an affirmation. I have a list that I've created. I'm happy to share that with any of you if you'd like it. Those are more geared toward adults. But I pick my affirmation for the day. I just randomly kind of pick it out. And then I spend a few minutes writing down, for me, what I need to get done. And then about 5 minutes of just breathing and meditating and figuring out kind of my day. And then I get on with my day. At the end of the day, I come back. I reread whatever that affirmation was, see how well I've done in incorporating that in my day, and then I journal some stuff down and get it out. So affirmations are definitely, that's part of my process. So how to incorporate affirmations in your kids' life. I love this. Get on up in the morning and pick an empowered statement. So maybe something that you're working on as a family is being kind or sharing. And so perhaps the affirmation can be, I am generous with my toys, or I share the first time. Maybe we have a problem with that, asking and sharing. So of course I'm going to grab something that we're working on personally as a family. So that's what I would do, is just get them on up and say, today this is what we're going to work on. What we're going to keep coming back to is, I am kind and I share the first time I'm asked when we're playing. And then throughout the day, whenever there's an upset or there's an issue, we're going to just come back to our pause breath. So bring in that reminder. When things start to get heated, let's pause for a second. Take that deep breath. I love little Daniel Tiger, who, you know, when you feel upset and you wanna roar, dun, 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 take a deep breath and count to four. So we pull that in frequently. So feel free to use a little bit of Daniel Tiger's adventure And that little jingle, sometimes our kids respond better to that. So let's do a little meditation. Let's come into our breath real quick. And you could do that real simple with your kids. So pick your affirmation. Come into your breath, maybe after breakfast, you find a moment to settle down before you get going in the day. And grab their little precious hands, look them right in the face and say, today we're going to practice sharing. And we're going to be kind when we're asked the first time to share. And then we're going to breathe into that. And in our mind's eye, we're going to imagine what that looks like, being kind. What does that look like to be kind on the first time? What does that look like when someone else is kind to us? How does that feel when we're being receptive in kindness? And as we continue breathing into our affirmation for the day, which is, I'm going to be kind and share the first time I'm asked to share my toy. Breathe in all of that kindness, all of those things you're going to say, all of that good sharing and fun playing that we get to do. And as we continue breathing, be on that receiving end of your friend or your sibling being kind and sharing with you on the first time that you ask. Feel how good that feels, and now we're going to share and exchange in kindness together. And that's what I encourage y'all to do. So as parents, we have such an amazing opportunity. Caregivers, parents, teachers, whatever your role is, however you're interacting with children, that we get to teach them these amazing things. And however y'all can incorporate that and that little affirmations into our little loved one's heart. And I love hearing my little loved ones say kind things to each other and really build each other up. And that's the beauty. So have a great day. Be safe today. Let's celebrate all of our wonderful independence. What a great opportunity to share with our kids what independence and freedom in America look like. Thank you so much. We'll see you guys tomorrow for story time. Bye.